Only 6% of people affected with COVID need hospitalization. If our country needs to deal with only this 6%, our death rate would be far below what it is today, and medical care would be available for those who need it. Let's look at the 94% who are affected with COVID and what is their best option. You are tested positive and you have either no symptoms or very mild symptoms, like a cold, cough, fever, body pains, weakness. This means that your immunity is working well against the virus and keeping it under control. And in a matter of 1 week to 10 days, all these symptoms will settle down. You may develop a loss of smell and taste along the way, but you will recover without any complication with simple over-the-counter medications like Dolo 650, home remedies, Ayurveda and homeopathy. Be in constant telephonic touch with your family doctor. Keep him informed on a daily basis. I have treated over 1300 people this way successfully. I strongly believe that over 94% of the people affected with COVID can be treated this way. Where are we going wrong? RT-PCR is the main test for diagnosing COVID, and it is only about 65 to 70% accurate, which means the 30-35% may be positive but will still show as negative. Not testing for COVID. Let us assume that every cold, cough, fever that happens to us now is COVID. We isolate ourselves and follow the rules which are laid down by the government, and we treat it as I have advised above and be done with it in a week or 10 days time. Testing for COVID. Once you are tested positive for COVID, you follow the above line of treatment and be done with it in 1 week to 10 days time. But this is possible only in 10% of those who have tested positive. Let me explain what happens to the rest 90% who are tested positive. Panic. With the second wave hitting us hard and the fear surrounding it, the moment you are tested positive, all hell breaks loose. You are flooded with advice from relatives, friends, colleagues, each one telling you their experiences and all the gory details from the news and the social media, and you get scared. You hardly have any symptoms, but the moment you know you are positive and you hear all their advice, you start to panic. When you panic, your breathing pattern changes. You breathe shallow, and in doing so, you pull carbon dioxide in your lungs and you begin to feel breathless. You are told that the lungs are getting affected, but the fact is that your anxiety is what is causing your breathlessness. Now you are asked to do the following investigations: a D-dimer, a C-reactive protein and a CT scan of the chest. A D-dimer. Elevated levels of D-dimer are associated with any inflammation and any disease activity. It is only when the levels are extremely high it indicates a clotting problem. C-reactive protein. A high level of C-reactive protein in the blood is a marker of any inflammation. It can be caused by a wide variety of conditions. Both the above tests are not specific for COVID. They are just supportive evidence of inflammation and infection. CT scan of the chest. More than 80% of the COVID patients show ground glass appearance in their CT scan. The moment you see the report, everyone says that your lungs are involved and you are in trouble. But that's not true. The COVID virus has a tendency to affect the lungs and to produce inflammatory changes in the lungs. Ground glass opacity is not specific to COVID. It is seen in many inflammations and infections. These, in most cases, resolve on their own. Now, your doctor starts you on an antiviral, Remdesivir, which the WHO says is not effective against COVID, then an antibiotic, and then a steroid is added to the prescription to be on the safe side. Remember, when you are in panic, your doctor who is treating you will also go into panic and ask you to get admitted. After all, he is human and he is answerable for you. What you need to understand is that your immunity is doing a great job in containing the COVID virus. That is why you hardly have any symptoms. All these medicines are very strong and have a lot of side effects. When you consume these, they together crush your natural immunity, which is doing a great job, and you begin to get worse. Your condition deteriorates and you end up in the hospital. The medical system is doing its best, but it is overwhelmed and in the process of collapsing. You need to use your common sense and logic and decide which way you want to deal with the COVID when you get affected by it. The authorities are now saying that COVID is spreading through the air and not a droplet infection anymore, which means the spread is very fast. The way the second wave is hitting us, the chances are that most of us at some time or the other is going to get affected by the COVID. And by then, we need to be ready with our choice. By choosing option one, there is a high chance that you will be done with the COVID without even realizing that you had COVID. You will not invite panic and unnecessarily stress and hospitalization. You will not unnecessarily block hospital beds and leave them to the 6% who truly needs them. The choice is yours. Take care.